Not long after graduating high school, something strange happened. One early morning, I found myself in bed, awake but unable to move or speak. Trapped in this state, I tried to scream but couldn't. Then I realized that a spirit-like creature was on my bed strangling me. I mean, this experience was bizarre, but it took me on a long journey around the world to study this phenomenon and try to understand what is the science behind sleep paralysis. So sleep paralysis is this transition-like state between wakefulness and rapid eye movement sleep, or REM sleep. And during REM sleep, you have vivid, crisp, lifelike dreams. And to prevent you from acting out these dreams and hurting yourself, your brain temporarily paralyzes the entire body. Now, this is a smart thing because it prevents you from hurting yourself. Sometimes you wake up while you're still under the spell of REM paralysis, leaving you stuck. In a sense, wakefulness and the dream world collide. So these conflicting signals, you know, messages to your body to move, move, and no feedback coming back from the body, it creates a confusion and your sense of body image gets all distorted. Now, the way your brain deals with this confusion is by building your body image for you. So it says, let me, you know, hallucinate what your body image looks like, and in a sense, like, autocorrect or, you know, filling in the blank, it will create your body image for you. The result is bizarre bodily hallucinations. You can see your limbs rotate in the air or sink into the bed, or your entire body may project out there in space. You have an out-of-body experience. Now, this body image distortion also impacts your ability to distinguish between self and other. The sense that I am me and you are you. And as the barrier between self and other dissolves, you mistake your projected body for a separate entity with its own free will. In my research in over 6 countries, we found that cultural explanations can have a big impact on how people experience sleep paralysis. Throughout history, there have been stories of people seeing and sensing ghosts during sleep. There are different beliefs for this. And in Egypt, people blame a jinn, an evil genie of sorts. In Italy, people talk about a pandafica, which is a giant cat or a witch attacking you. And in Denmark, people attribute it to things like stress. Those who have striking or supernatural beliefs about it tend to have it much more. They also have longer paralysis and greater fear. Once sleep paralysis is interpreted through the lens of fear, it leads to more anxiety and unwanted nighttime awakenings and more sleep paralysis. This vicious cycle, which I call the panic hallucination model, continues to feed on itself until sleep paralysis becomes chronic, prolonged, and potentially even traumatizing. So how do you help these people? I've developed a psychological treatment called meditation relaxation therapy applied directly during sleep paralysis. In a pilot study in Italy, we showed promising results. A 50% plus reduction in sleep paralysis after using this therapy for only 8 weeks. But of course, we need to do more research to be sure of its benefit. Now, I still experience sleep paralysis now and then, and I get to explore my own theories. Sometimes I try to imagine ghosts just to see if I can create my own monsters. Like, I'm usually unable to complete these experiments out of horror. But instead, I resort to meditation relaxation therapy just to calm myself down. But scientists like myself are among a select group of people who can say they're working while sleeping.